Remove the Milrinone bag from the refrigerator 2 hours before the infusion or bag change is due. Make sure to remove the bag that has the soonest use-by date. Check the label on the Milrinone bag. Make sure the label information is correct, including the patient's name, date of birth, use-by date, and the infusion rate, or amount of Milrinone you should give. When it's time to set up the infusion, clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. Clean your work surface with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Cover your work surface with a paper drape or clean towel. This work surface is now a safe zone or a clean area. Put the supplies and equipment you need on the safe zone, including the Milrinone bag, a Curlin 6000 infusion pump, Curlin IV tubing with an appropriate size filter, a back check valve if it's not included in the IV tubing package, a needleless connector if it's due to be changed, and several disinfecting pads. Put 2C batteries and an AC power cord, if you'd like to use one to power the pump, next to the safe zone. Replace the pump batteries before you set up the infusion. To insert new batteries, move the gray bar on the back of the pump to the unlock position. Slide the battery door down to remove it from the pump. Pull the plastic tab to remove the old batteries. Replace them with 2 new batteries. Replace the battery door by sliding it into the notches at the bottom of the pump. Move the gray bar to the lock position. Remove the Curlin IV tubing from its package. If there's a back check valve in the package, set it to the side. Twist to remove the tab from the yellow flow stop device in the IV tubing. Remove the back check valve from its package. Remove the cap from the back check valve and from the end of the IV tubing. Take care not to touch the open end of the valve or the tubing. Attach the back check valve to the open end of the IV tubing. If the needleless connector is due to be changed, you need to attach a new connector to the end of the new IV tubing. Scrub the hub of the needleless connector for 15 to 30 seconds using a disinfecting pad. Allow the hub to air dry completely. Do not fan or blow on the hub to speed up drying. Remove the cap from the end of the IV tubing. Take care not to touch the open end of the IV tubing or the hub of the needleless connector. Attach the connector to the IV tubing. Remove the cover from the Milrinone bag's tubing port. Take care not to touch the open tubing port. Pull to remove the cap from the IV tubing spike. Push the tubing spike straight into the tubing port on the Milrinone bag using a twisting back and forth motion. Take care not to spike through the side of the tubing port. Keep pushing and twisting the spike until it reaches the Milrinone fluid in the bag and cannot be pushed any further. Lift the latch on the top of the pump to open the pump door. Insert the blue tubing guide into the holder on the right side of the pump. Lay the tubing in the center of the gray track. Insert the yellow flow stop device into the holder on the left side of the pump. Close the pump door and press the latch down until it clicks. Press the on button on the pump. Listen for the beeps that tell you the self-tests are complete. Immediately after the self-test, the battery icon appears on the display window. Check to make sure the batteries are fully charged. The display window highlights Program. Press the Yes, Enter button. The display window shows Repeat RX. Press the Yes, Enter button. The pump automatically scrolls through the infusion program. Make sure the numbers on the pump match the pharmacy label on the Milrinone bag. If the pump scrolled too quickly for you to review the program, press the No button, then press the down arrow until you see Next. Press the Yes button. Use the down arrow to scroll through and verify that the numbers match the label. When you're finished, press the Yes button. Make sure the end of the IV tubing is on the safe zone. Hold the filter upright. Do not turn the filter upside down. Press and hold the prime button. Keep holding the filter upright while you prime the IV tubing. When the Milrinone fluid reaches the tip of the IV tubing or new needleless connector, release the prime button. Check the IV tubing and filter to make sure there are no air bubbles larger than soda pop bubbles. If there are bubbles, repeat the priming steps by pressing and holding the prime button until all air bubbles are removed from the tubing. When all the air bubbles in the tubing and filter are gone, close the clamp on the IV tubing. Press the Yes, Enter button to exit the priming screen. The pump beeps when it's time to change the bag. And the display window shows Infusion Complete. Press the Run Pause button, then the On-Off button to turn the pump off. Close the clamp on the IV catheter. Disconnect the tubing from the needleless connector. Set the disconnected pump, tubing, and bag to the side. Clean your hands with soap and water or alcohol-based hand gel. If you are changing the needleless connector, use a disinfecting pad to scrub the joint between the connector and the IV catheter for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow the area to air dry. Remove the old connector from the end of the IV catheter. Take care not to touch the open end of the catheter. Use a disinfecting pad to scrub the threads on the IV catheter hub for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow the catheter hub to air dry completely. Remove the cap from the new needleless connector on the end of the IV tubing, then attach the connector to the catheter hub. When you're ready to connect the new Milrinone bag and tubing, scrub the hub of the needleless connector with a disinfecting pad for 15 to 30 seconds. Allow the hub to air dry completely. Attach the new Milrinone bag's IV tubing to the needleless connector. Open the clamps on the IV tubing and IV catheter. Press the Run button on the pump to start the infusion. Check to make sure the pump is running. You'll see a flashing green light when the pump is running. Instruct the caregiver to check the pump 3 times a day, morning, afternoon, and night, to make sure it's running and the fluid level in the bag is going down. If you need to press the pause button to stop the pump during an infusion, it's important to know how to restart the infusion. This is usually only done for blood collection or troubleshooting. If you stop the pump and want to continue the infusion where you left off, make sure Resume is highlighted. Press the Yes, Enter button, then press the Run button. Remove the IV tubing from the old infusion pump. Remove the label from the IV bag and put the used IV tubing, bag, and all other used supplies into the trash. Clean the pump using a damp cloth with soap and water or a disinfecting wipe. Store the pump for use as the backup pump. There are 2 ways to power the Curlin pump, AC power and battery power. To run the pump using AC power, push the power cord adapter into the port on the bottom of the pump. Plug the other end of the adapter into an AC power outlet. To run the pump on batteries, disconnect the power cord adapter from the pump. To check the battery charge level during an infusion, press Power Check, located on the number 2 button. The display window shows how much power is left in the batteries. Change the batteries anytime you see less than 1/4 battery power left. When the batteries are low or empty, the pump beeps, and the display window shows low C batteries or empty battery. Press the pause button, then the on-off button to turn the pump off and change the batteries. To continue the infusion, press the on-off button to turn on the pump. The display window highlights Program. Press the Yes, Enter button. The display window highlights Resume. Press the Yes, Enter button. Then press Run to restart the Milrinone infusion. Check to make sure the green light is flashing and the pump is running.